Joseph to his parents and sisters, Father Joe to those he has served since 1953, Bishop Joe since his ordination in 1994. Who is this man you honor tonight? The tidings called him a priest with a ready smile. I agree. I contacted some of you to help me convey why he is so beloved. The number one message I heard, he is a holy and he's a humble priest. Another stopped me and said, Steve, I really mean that. I see his holiness when I'm with him and during his homilies. Another one said, Steve, he's a priest who is loved. So many use that word, love. Others spoke of the joy of being with Bishop Joe on his pilgrimages to the Holy Land, probably over 20. A holy man who is a beloved pastor. That's not a bad summary at this phase of his life. I didn't mention his degrees because that's not what people wanted me to talk about. They said, talk about the man, the priest, the bishop, the pastor. Look at him. He was born 86 years ago. He was raised in Glendale by Jim and Peg Sartoris, the only son with three sisters. Two are gone, but they're here in spirit from heaven. His three sisters and so many wonderful religious women influenced him, and I believe their influence is one reason he is so devoted to the role of women in the church. As an aside, let me ask you this. Just ask Bishop Joe, who was in charge when he and Sister Mary Jean Meyer traveled together to the Holy Land? 60 years a priest. Let me say that again. 60 years a priest. This man served from Dolores Mission to Nativity in South Los Angeles, a parish he still supports and loves, to St. Margaret Mary in Lomita, and so many other communities. St. Margaret Mary was his last parish before he was ordained a bishop, and he was followed by Monsignor Mark Trudeau, who will now take over at St. John's Seminary. How special. And let me conclude with this. 20 years a bishop, yet he continues to serve after he retired in 2002. He's not slowed down. He continues to help in his parish ministry, in his prison ministry, in his pilgrimages to the Holy Land. This is a man who's not retiring. Let me give you an example. In October, this man took pilgrims to Turkey for 15 days and then immediately joined the Archbishop's tour for 10 days in Israel. One last story. He doesn't know I'll tell you this, but maybe this will capture the essence of this man I honor. In 1972, his father, Jim Sartoris, was near death. Bishop Joe was there at his bedside. I was there to see it. But earlier he had given his word that he would testify for a young man in a criminal case. He kept his commitment. He went to court as a pastor and then returned to see his father off to heaven. His pastoral role has never ceased. This is the man I introduced to you tonight. A priest with a ready smile, a pastor who is loved, and yes, my friend and uncle who continues to baptize, confirm, forgive, marry, and bury. May God bless him with many more years of humble service. I give you Bishop Joe Sartoris.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Stephen. I appreciate your words, and I'm glad you didn't tell everything you know about me. Really want to thank you, Archbishop, committee, for the honor. When you said it would be for the seminary, that really did it. I'd like to think I stand here tonight representing all the priests in those 75 years that have passed through St. John's Seminary, and also so many wonderful laymen who tried to discern a vocation and found that God was calling them elsewhere. They're some of our finest laymen in the Archdiocese. I'm grateful to the seminary, and I want to acknowledge them and the seminarians here tonight. I also think I'd like to stand here representing all of our priests, that I'm kind of a token that's being honored in their place. Now, Monsignor Vatican mentioned his love of being a parish priest. It's the only thing I ever wanted to be. And I've been so pleased to serve those years here in the Archdiocese as a parish priest. Even as a bishop, I tried to do that. I want to thank my family. You heard them. They're noisy. But they're wonderful. You know, family in a priest's life is very important. They keep you honest. They keep you humble. But they support and love you and allow that wonderful gift of family to be so strong in our life. So I salute them and thank them publicly tonight. But all the parishes, my first parish of Pacific Palisades with Monsignor Vatican, he was a senior in high school at that time, all the way through the many parishes that I served, especially St. Margaret Mary's, now I'm working in Downey on Sunday. It's just been a wonderful privilege to serve the people of God. Finally, all of you have supported these dinners. Someone mentioned that. For 25 years, that's marvelous. You have no idea, I don't think, of the good you've done for children, schools, families, institutions by your generosity in coming to these dinners. Most of all, just thank the Lord. He's been good to all of us here in the Archdiocese, and I praise him and trust him that he'll keep me going as long as he wants an old pastor to keep working. Thank you, and God bless you.